To my valley from programtom.com/dev here. In this video, I'm gonna show you the UI navigation of my notification center app. So there will be a loading screen where the app will decide if it is locked or not, and if it is not locked, the user will be redirected to the login screen with possibility of signing in with Google or signing in with QR code from the web application. For now, I'm gonna remove this now with email and stuff, as it requires high level of security that it requires a lot of testing and thinking about it to figure out all the edge cases of security. And yeah, it's better to have a OAuth or directly login with QR from web. So after this, there will be an app list. This will be a public apps list, where you could view details on them and subscribe, or if you have already subscribed, opt out to events. Basically, these apps may be events, so these apps may be even actually not events, but organizers. This may be, for example, organizers of a special type of dancing clubs. So this app could be good for DJs, for music organizer, for dancing organizers, for every kind of every kind and type of events that anybody could potentially subscribe when there will be such. So apps is just a wrapper of what could be, what a user could subscribe to. So for example, DJs and some events creators could create an app and could allow subscribers to subscribe or opt out. So here there will be a general type of information about the app, what types of events and stuff here the user will get. And there could be potentially a third screen that is the actual invites to an event. This will be the notification, and this will be notification from a certain app. Yeah, I'll draw an arrow here. Yeah, this will be an arrow from here, or maybe no, from here to here. So this will be always present screen, and this will be list of events that you have already received notifications from. And here I think of allowing the user to scan a QR or receive invitation to private apps or private events. So somebody could potentially create an app that will not be visible by all, and he or she could get a notification to not registered here, not present for all users events, and this could be potentially a paid functionality. So this is the logic I'm planning, and I'm having here an generate an app navigation generator. So here are the code generator. So so far I've implemented several types of navigations, Flutter one with all the paths generated in the navigation, go route, get his ways of navigating, and auto route with river pod. But here is with path generator. So I'm thinking of implementing a better node generation version of this. So basically this will allow to have all the functionality flow, and one by one all the screens and all the functionalities of the navigation between the screens will be able to I could able to grab one of the functionalities and implement it independently, having like a skeleton of the app. So this is something that is very commonly implemented in multi-development, multi-team applications, where functionalities and screens are separated to several developers, and a requirement to have such functionality divided is to have a router, have the navigation figured out, even without actual logic, actual login, actual UI. When you have the navigation, one could grab one screen and only touch, in terms of files, only minimal amount of common files. So this is one of the greatest challenges, to have the common code laid out, so minimal amount of merge, git merge happens during project development. So here is the logic so far.